Alright folks, today we are grilling a stuffed baguette and I call this one beef and egg baguette. So stay tuned. It's time to grill. Let's get started with firing up the grill. This is my Landmann Triton gas grill. We're gonna turn on the left and the right burner, which is the way I do it most of the time, so we have enough indirect heat in the middle. The temperature is about 140 degrees Celsius and we're gonna grill 4 to 5 slices of breakfast bacon. I have already prepared some softball eggs. You will need about 6 or 7. It depends a little bit of the size of your baguette. And it's easier to peel softball eggs in cold water. That's what I did here. And it's our goal to have a nice and waxy consistency of the eggs after grilling it inside the baguette. After peeling the eggs, we can keep going with the rest of the stuffing, and you will need some ground beef. This is completely fresh ground beef. This is fresh sausage meat from a local butcher nearby. Sometimes people on my social media are complaining about grilling things not completely well done. For me, the quality of that meat is so high and it's so good, I would eat it raw anyway. This is a French baguette. This is also bought local here at my local bakery, which is close to the butcher. And just open it up with a knife and take out the complete inside part of the bread, so we have enough space for our stuffing. And here's the point where it comes to the size of your baguette. It might vary with the number of eggs and your amount of ground beef. Let's get started with some cheese. Grated cheese is always working. I like that color. It's grated cheddar. I'm gonna place those 7 eggs inside the baguette and then take little pieces of that ground beef sausage mixture and place it between the egg or between egg and bread. That's pretty easy. If you have the feeling now that you want to create this dish at home too and you have no clue about the ingredients and the measurements, make sure to check the video description. Just open it up and you will find a complete list with all measurements and all ingredients for that size of baguette. You will also find some more information inside that video description, maybe my link to my new book or the link to my fan pages. You can join me on Instagram, on Facebook, and new on TikTok. After we have done the stuffing between egg and bread and between egg and egg, just take more of that ground beef and close your baguette completely. Make sure not to make it too thick. It should be thin enough, but it should be covering everything completely. Now take out the bacon stripes. They don't have to be that brown because they will still go on later as flakes for crust and keep on cooking, and place the baguette on the warming rack in the middle. After 20 minutes I took the baguette down on the lower part of the grill, and in the meantime I just made some bacon flakes here. I'm completely hooked up on bacon flakes. After 30 minutes now, take some barbecue rub and glaze your baguette on top, sprinkle over those bacon flakes, and then keep grilling for another 30 minutes, or something between 20 and 30 minutes. Here is the result. I hope the ground beef is still a little bit pink in the center and we have some waxy egg yolk. Okay, looks like a winner. I really like that. Look at that. How cool is that? It's full of flavor and the combination of egg, bacon, barbecue sauce, crispy bread is awesome. Of course, as always, I'm gonna give this a shot. Please make sure to hit that like button, leave me a comment, and subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. Also, as mentioned, visit my fan pages. You can find me everywhere. It's fun, I promise. If you want to create those dishes at home, don't forget to tag me on social media so I can check it out. Anyway, that's awesome. Thanks for watching. I'm out. See you.